Jerry Manthe, an aspiring actress from Los Angeles.
Keith actually ran ahead to go scout out where the camp was because we were all getting pretty tired, and the last leg of that walk was really difficult. When we got to our camp, I was considering at that point anything and everything anybody was doing or saying as a strategic move. The tension between Keith and I think him and I kind of rubbed each other the wrong way.
Watch, right here, watch. Let me just show you.
Keith and I didn't start off on a very good foot just because of some of the condescending remarks he made to me. And he might very well not even be aware that he does it, but I'm not the kind of person to just let it slide off my back.
Good job! Good job!
Believe me, when he goes out, I'm hoping more than anybody that he's gonna come back with some fish and some shrimp, you know, have a big seafood buffet.
Any luck out there?
No, but there are fish out there. I saw quite a few.
But it's not happening, and he's not a fisherman, obviously. Should keep his day job. It didn't make sense. It didn't make sense. Like, how could a gourmet chef not know how to make rice? I remembered that with flour and water, you can create some sort of dough.
You know what we're gonna do while you're doing that? We're gonna go get some more wood.
All right.
So we'll be back in a while.
Keith is very threatened by the fact that I made this tortilla this morning. That's why I heard them when they went up on the hill and they were gathering wood. He was talking again about what he's going to do with the rice and the vegetables and this. And you know, you just have to laugh. You just have to laugh. I felt a little bit bad about it, but at the same time, you know, I felt like it was time for somebody to come in and take charge and change the food situation. Keith has gone out of his way to compliment me a lot now, to like try and smooth the edges. And I see right through it. I don't think his compliments are necessarily very genuine.
That's good. I'm so glad they put weed in there. Thanks, Jerry.
You know, the morale right now is kind of low, but I think the tortilla made everybody spark up. So I'm really stoked about that. And I got a few other tricks to pull out of my sleeve.
Jerry reported to the rest of us that she had seen Cal chewing a brown substance, what she thought was beef jerky.
And I saw him put something in his mouth, and it was like dark brown colored, shredded looking sort of thing.
Jerry blatantly said that she saw something look just like beef jerky go into his mouth, and I believe her, actually.
I guarantee it was.
I saw him chewing, but you saw
I saw him chewing.
Yeah. I mean, to have your own team member possibly be holding food behind you and surviving on their own little private stash while the rest of us are starving, basically, is not a good way to start off on the right foot with a bunch of strangers. Well, in order to put grass in your mouth, you have to go get grass first. And I don't think you get grass out of your pocket. It's razor. And I think that that's the hugest sign of guilt, is to give to the people who have just accused you of something that is very serious.
I will totally take you up on that. That's very gracious of you, actually.
No, no problem.
But no, we're gonna talk right now. I think Kel is a liar and a cheat. And as much as I don't want to believe that to be the truth, he would probably be the first one I'd want to vote off.
Why are you cooking if he's a chef?
I knew you were gonna go there. The rice was a little pasty the first couple of nights, and it got to the point where none of us wanted to eat it. And that's when I felt I needed to step in, because we were losing strength. Our morale was down. I mean, when you don't want to even eat, that's a really bad sign of bad things to come. So I just took it upon myself.
First person voted out of the Yogacore tribe, Kel. Kel, the tribe has spoken.
Hey, I'm proud of you.
I got it off the hook.
I couldn't stop smiling. Keith said there were no fish. He said, there's no fish out there. Him and Kel both were saying that for days and days.
Holy crap.
They were practically jumping in the boats. I think right now everybody's pretty happy that Keith is there to cook the fish that we've been catching. I know sometimes he says things to other people that kind of rub them the wrong way, but I'm probably the one who gets irritated with him the most. I'm aware of that.
You like crunchy peanut butter or creamy?
Crunchy.
Gotta have crunchy.
Yeah.
Black coffee or cream and sugar?
Cream and sugar. I'd really like it if Colby and I got together. He's exactly my type. Plus, he's a cowboy, and I'm such a sucker for cowboys.
Cake or ice cream?
Oh, cake.
Oh, I dig ice cream.
If it came down to me having to vote for Colby, I would. Everybody's kind of getting a little lethargic. The fish definitely helped. That was a big morale booster, but since we're kind of on a downslide right now, and it kind of scares me a little bit.
Touch the table.
Everybody.
Touch the table. Kucha.
There's been five of us, myself, Colby, Mitchell, Amber, and Tina, who've kind of decided to all vote the same.
Jerry, who here would you say you're closest to so far?
I've been very fortunate in my ability to bond with Amber and Mitchell and Colby in particular. I think friendship does enter into it at some point, but it's very important to keep that separate from the game. It's two totally different things, and that's where it gets tricky. This is probably one of the most difficult things for me to do right now. It's purely strategic. It's nothing personal. I am gonna miss you dearly.
And a very sad Mad Dog. Need to bring me a torch, Mad Dog. Mad Dog, the tribe has spoken.
It's all I could do to keep from laughing out loud. At Tribal Council, Jeff asked me who I felt I had built friendships with. And immediately after I said it, I kind of sucked it back up because I realized that I was basically challenging people to vote for me, which doesn't put me in a very good position. The only way it would work is if Keith convinced Tina and Colby, to vote against me.
Right.
And you and us three voted against Keith. It would be three and three.
And then you
and me with the most votes. I'd be gone. This is definitely the first time I've felt a little bit threatened. And I guess I deserve it after making that pompous remark at the Tribal Council.
Colby could be talked into things easily.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking too.
He's not real strong in his own opinion. He sways a lot between what people tell him.
Colby does seem to be the one we're focused on and trying to ensure he's not changing his mind. Colby was pretty excited about going out hunting for a pig, and I think it's a brilliant idea, especially with the fires right now, because a lot of wildlife has been flushed this way. Fire pretty much stopped. It's always a possibility that it could jump the river and come over here. I think it's highly unlikely because there's no wind, nothing. I think Colby is definitely separating the game from any relationship with me. I think it takes a strong person to do that, quite honestly, especially when there's obviously, you know, some attraction between us.
I don't want you to lose an ounce of sleep worrying about what Tina's thinking or doing or anything.
I'm not losing any sleep. I just know that she's thinking ahead. I just want to feed her to the drug. So.
I'm not saying I'm holding out on making a deal with you to see how this thing plays out. I'm saying there's no sense in even making a deal, because if we go into the merge undermanned, it's all for naught, you know?
Don't worry about it. It's, you know, it's not like you're making a deal with the devil here. I'm a little leery of Colby, and I can tell actually that he's started distancing himself from me a lot more.
I like hanging out with you, so it, you know, it just makes sense to me to approach you with
it. Make you a deal. It's me, you, and Amber. Do it again.
Make me a deal? What is that?
Well, you were wanting to strike a deal earlier.
Alicia says, C, you should never place wet rocks near the fire. C is right. Put your hand.
We have a tie. We have another tie.
In a long vote, Mitchell, the tribe has spoken.
It's pretty dramatic evening. I think our little
group of common voters has been busted up. It's a whole new ballgame right now.
What we did was strategic, and it was to help the team out, and I know it did that.
I have, you know, I'm not harboring any ill feelings whatsoever about the whole deal. We still are more powerful if the three of us are voting the same.
I'm still voting just like I did last night, based on who the strongest, who I think's got what it takes to make it in. Maybe tomorrow I might be thinking a whole lot different, but right now I'm not.
I mean, it's basically the end of any alliance, pretty much.
Jerry, I don't care. I don't care about that stage of it. I mean, all I care about is doing everything we can to win the next two immunity challenges. That's the only thing I can focus on right now.
We haven't caught any fish for, I think, 2 days now. The whole hunger thing. That, for me, has been a huge hurdle. We haven't been catching fish again, and the other team is eating chickens and pigs and eggs, you know, and here we are over here, starving to death.
You have any?
No luck.
Those are the things that I didn't really think going into this that were going to bother me, but it has. It kind of took over making the travois. I knew that the idea that I had would work, and everybody was just kind of standing around and talking, and no one was doing anything, so I just kind of grabbed the bull by the horns. There's a lot of pressure on us today, a lot, but let's not forget also to have fun with this.
It is going to take every ounce of keenness, of smarts, of strength, of everything we have. The excuses are done. Check them at the door, and let's get down to business.
Go! Around! Around!
Come on! Go, go, go.
Hurry up! Ah!
Yeah! I fear I might go psycho. And I'm not kidding.
I had a discussion with Colby regarding chocolate and how chocolate releases the same endorphins that sex does. And since none of us are having sex, that's probably why we keep reverting to the chocolate discussions.
I'm gonna bathe myself in chocolate.
I can't get over. I just want to bite into one of those so bad it's unbelievable. Like a peppermint patty.
Right now, I can actually, in my wildest fantasy, picture pouring hot chocolate all over some hot dude's bod and having sex while licking it off at the same time. That's like my ultimate fantasy right now. I think Colby's afraid of me because this fantasy I have about chocolate and sex definitely involves him.
God, I can't take it.
Get something going. This is crazy.
Would help if you weren't quite so pessimistic about ideas that other people have other than your own.
I wasn't pessimistic. I'm not picking on you about your tomatoes.
You already did on the way here. You said, I don't think that can be bad.
That's good. Well, then this will be good. We got fried green tomatoes.
That's so well.
Yeah, I don't think it's done yet, Keith.
There's a water right
there. It looks totally soupy. It needs to sit there till it's dry. It's going to be soupy. You got to let the rice sit.
You can't. There's double the amount of rice that's sticking to the bottom and burning.
It's all breaking up, though.
It's because you kept stirring it. You gotta leave it in there.
Stop it! Both of you! Or you're going to timeout!
If Kucha wins this reward, it would suck. They don't deserve it. They've been eating like kings over there, and I think it'd be really nice of them if they threw this one for us.
Perfect.
There's a weird tension in the camp right now. Colby wants to just think about nothing but the game, and then Amber and Tina are braiding each other's hair and talking about college days.
Much further away than everybody else. And it's funny because my sophomore year,
everybody was kind of chit-chatting and being very lighthearted, and I needed to get more centered and focused.
It goes around my head, it catches the bat.
So I knew that I needed to get away from camp.
Everyone else in the camp is looking at it as if we lose today, that's it. We're all going to be sitting ducks. We're going to get picked off one by one.
I see it almost as an opportunity to finagle my way into the other tribe a bit and mix things up and freak some people out. If they're gonna pick us off one by one, I'm at least gonna cause a big ruckus going down. I'm gonna wreak a little havoc.
It's a little strange. There has been an accident at the Kucha camp, and one of their members has been evacuated. As a result, there will be no immunity challenge today, and all five of you will continue to the merge. You will receive further instructions soon.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's awful.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Hopefully they're all right.
I wonder what this means. Like, I wonder if we, if they have five and five.
They have someone hurt. They have five now, right?
Right. I hope it's not a snake bite. I hope it's something that heals, like, a broken, you know.
We do have a lot at stake. If we slip anything out regarding the voting situation, we're done.
The only thing to break the tie is past votes for the person who was voted for. If they were to vote for myself or Keith, we'd be out.
We first found out yesterday that we were merging with all five of us after the accident over at Kucha. We didn't really know whether to celebrate or feel bad.
Oh, man.
I don't want to talk about Keith in front of our guests.
So can smell that.
And if I voice my opinions about how I really feel about him, they're going to figure out that votes have been placed against him. We decided that I was going to make my famous tortilla, and we opened a can of whole peeled tomatoes.
I asked Alicia about their firewood situation. She said they have so much. They don't worry about the firewood at all.
They have a kitchen. They have all these wonderful things. We have nothing.
I agree. I'm totally for going.
I'm so stoked about going to their camp.
We're moving!
We were ready to pack up and move to Camp Kucha.
Roll up the flag inside.
The other black glove.
Should we need our fishing pole?
And when we looked at the map, it was a completely different spot.
Maybe they're doing the same thing and we're gonna have a whole new camp.
Oh. I thought about that.
Yep, I think that's what it is.
A spot that was untouched where we would have to build everything again from scratch.
Okay, building a new home is now up to you, but before you get started, you have two things to do. A flag must be made once your tribe's named. Here's a toast to your efforts. And the second half of the game.
Open it, open it, open it.
Toast, 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 toast.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
Wow. We get the party.
I swear I haven't been that excited since I was little. And so just completely overwhelmed with the fact that you've been starving and the fact that you're in the middle of nowhere and there's this spread in front of you. We are called the Barramundi Tribe. It's a great name for our new tribe because this is when things get slippery and sneaky and it's hard to catch people.
One for Jeff. That's five. Look at that. One for Colby. Colby.
Zero.
Zero. Jeff.
One that I know of.
Enough. Jeff, the tribe has spoken.
Today has been just so weird. I feel like a lot of distance between myself and everybody else right now.
We do have the advantage now. We're five. Kucha's four, but that's not relaxing me at all. It's the paranoia again setting in. We're in a situation where Tina and Keith could team up with the Kucha people. Cannot be complacent. Your back will be stabbed faster than you can spit.
No. It's open. One decent toss. One good meal. Look at that.
That's a good one.
Inch past 11.
I'm wet.
I don't even. Oh my god.
Yep. Close, but nose to guard.
Jerry's the winner.
Got it. You have it. You have it.
Oh my god. You beat me like a few inches.
Amber, you got the closest to me, and you scared my pants.
Bye, bye, guys.
Bye, guys.
Talk about Tina's being extra chipper. She's had a constant smile on her face since the merge. She's been talking in a different voice.
I know.
I want to go to this, want to go to that. Blah, 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 blah. It's unbelievable. She's a completely different person.
You gotta really keep our eye on Tina. Because she has been acting really weird, and I'm like so sure that she's gonna backstab us.
Oh, I totally agree. Well,
and she'd be doing it with people who would be ready to jump ship.
Yeah.
Jump right on her ship.
Mm-hmm. It's a completely different game, isn't it? Weird? Playing for yourself is definitely different.
So we need to talk to Colby.
Yeah.
It's making it to the end.
I expressed to Amber my concern with Tina and Keith taking off and gathering three coaches and coming after us. She said the same as me, like she wouldn't doubt it. After that whole episode with Tina before, it's not good for us to just assume that we can trust her.
Colby's kind of middle ground. Nobody really knows what he's going to do, and he's not really letting anyone on to what his plans are.
I mean, have you ever considered maybe even leading Keith and Tina to believe that you want the three of them to be the final three?
Keith and Tina?
Yeah.
And myself?
Have you ever thought maybe...
Well, they're fully convinced that's what's going to happen.
Oh, they are?
I mean, they've thought that
for a while.
Before the merge, yeah.
Oh,
and
really?
That's been my only,
you didn't tell
that's
me
been,
that.
Oh, I'm sorry. That's been my only bargain. That's been my only bargaining chips.
The biggest it's ever been.
I buy it. I believe him. Because to him right now, winning is everything. So, I mean, I'm looking at this whole thing right now as, yes, we are working as a team to get to a specific point.
And so that doesn't leave me feeling very vulnerable at this point. Alicia right now is our biggest threat by far. She's got the guns. And she out-strengthens even the men. The men are sweating it right now over Alicia. So I think she probably knows that, and it's probably very important to her to win immunity right now.
Alicia, not only do you intimidate the hell out of the women around here, but also the men. They are scared to death of you.
Final vote. Alicia. Alicia, tribe has spoken.
Colby. Yeah.
There we go.
That's funny.
Oh, there we go. That's the best level. Ready to rock?
Yeah. Ironically enough, I ended up being Colby's partner anyway. I think it's important that people are constantly reminded of the reality of our situation. There's nothing fair about this. And, you know, about winning.
You guys are going to the Great Barrier Reef.
There's got to be a little bit of animosity and jealousy from everyone else for winning two rewards in a row. It bothers me a little bit because I can see where that might affect people's voting. But on the other hand, I really couldn't give a flying crap at this point. We land on the beach and I see a boat sitting there. I'm like, what is going on? It couldn't possibly get any better. We get under this tent and there is just this spread. There's a basket full of all different kinds of fruits, wrapped sandwiches, a bag of Doritos, there's pasta salad and sweet potatoes and all these different vegetables.
Look at this.
The beach.
Look what you get here. A little brownie.
We feasted for a good while and then realized, I wonder how everybody else is doing. But I knew. Here we are in the middle of the Great Barrier Reef. It was just too close to paradise. The setting, it was very, very romantic on top of everything else. I even looked at him at one point and I was like, this is one hell of a first date, Colby.
I couldn't have come out here with a better person than Colby. We're having a great time. We're getting to know each other outside of the game and outside of that environment. This is basically the perfect honeymoon without the sex.
Barramundi right now is, I'm not really looking forward to it, but I at least am going back feeling rejuvenated and renewed and a little bit more like my true self. Because man, after 26 days of putting on the game face and being this tough, you know, don't mess with me chick, you know, I got a tender side too. I feel like a little bit of that was touched today.
Kobe's little shell maneuver was most definitely strategy. For me, in a perfect world, it'll be me and him sitting up there in front of the jury. I find him and myself to be the most even on the playing field, more than anybody else here. And so now, because of that little maneuver, I'm thinking he's got one up on me for sure. The main thing that's changing now that Nick has won today's immunity is that we were all going to vote him off camp. So it was discussed on the walk back to camp who we would be voting for instead. It was decided by the ex-Ogacore tribe that Elizabeth would be the next one to go.
I've never in my life met anyone more likable and more lovable. Because you are such a likable person, it is a definite threat.
Five votes, Jerry. That's enough. You need to bring me your torch.
Checkmate, you guys got me. Good game.
Jerry, tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go.
You know, it's funny because I absolutely knew this was coming. It must have been my remark about how this game isn't fair. I'm pretty sure that's what set everyone off. I've had a great time, and I'm still up for sitting around with everybody having a beer and laughing about this whole thing.